Focus on the video. Focus. Don't look at me. Just focus.
Thank you. here I've been.
So
Thank you. Before you set up or before you decide to be an entrepreneur, years before you register to the commission. There are some questions that you must ask yourself. If all these questions are able to answer them and your responses are positive, then you are on the right path. Let me go through these questions. I'm sure we can start with the lesson.
You must have a mission, and your you must also have a vision. And normally your vision must be bigger than your mission. You get it. If you are selling one thing, you can coin a mission like, okay, I'm here to provide the best watching for my customers in my neighborhood. That is your mission statement. And your vision statement could be like, since you are selling watches, your vision statement could be like, okay, in the next 5 years or 10 years to come, I see my watches to be the best, breaking through barriers and selling across Africa. You get it. Something like this could be your vision statement. You get it. So you must know whether your company should be global or local, and this is how you can start from. And I, growing up, I used to have this, there was this inscription in my room. And if I can remember, it was like, if I cannot do great things in great ways, I will do small things in great ways. I don't know if you understand what I just said. If you cannot do great things in great ways, you can do smaller things. Not everybody could have plans to start big. You get it. So from the little that you have, your own savings and support from your family, you can start smaller things in bigger ways. That is what the statement I made means. You get it. Okay, let me quickly write to leadership. I've talked about entrepreneurship. Yeah, okay. So let me run through it quickly. When we say leadership, or leader, what do you understand by leadership or leader? You can say a leader is someone who is able to motivate his followers in achieving a common goal. That is a leader. Someone who is able to motivate his followers in achieving a common goal. And leadership is a process or an act. So that would be a process of motivating your fellow colleagues or your group in achieving a common or a similar goal. That is what leadership is all about. And in leadership, we have types of leadership. We can talk of the authoritarian style of leadership, the democratic. I know you've heard of these things that I'm mentioning. We have the democratic type. The type of leadership that allows his followers to bring their ideas. That's when we talk about the democratic style of leadership. If he wants to do he has a policy or an agenda he wants to embark on, you assemble his mates. Shall anyone do anything about this? How can we do this? Everybody will bring his ideas, you put them all together, and together they will put the ideas in. That purpose. And we have the authoritarian style. That's one. He doesn't seek anybody's permission. If today we are eating whitey, you eat whitey. Whether you eat or you don't, he is imposing the whitey on you. You get it. That's the authoritarian style of leadership. And let's talk about some characteristics of a leader. As a leader, you should be able to motivate your followers. You should be responsible, you must be accountable to them. You get it. Those are some of the traits that makes you a good leader. And I'm sure we have a lot of leaders here. Like some years to come, you see some ministers here, you see some foreign affairs, CEOs and staffs here. So this is all I will talk about leadership. And let me draw down on this and bring it to a close. Realizing the importance of self-sustainability. It is important. The reason why I'm going through this leadership entrepreneurship topic is that we need to be sustainable. You get it. We find ourselves in a world that after school, we are not able to get a job. If we are fortunate, but statistics show that there are a lot of graduates in Ghana. They are strong, they are willing to work, but they are not getting jobs. So it's very good that we start thinking about what we can do. Because when you complete school, your mother will not be giving you job money again. You have to find your own job money. You get it. So it's about time you start thinking about what you can do. Just look around yourself. Hey, I can sing, bro. Let me create this YouTube page. Put my videos there. Small, small, small. You get plenty of followers. You'll be paid on YouTube. You know, you can sew. If it's a collaboration that you want to do, you find your friend, you join hands, you join hands. Small, small, you can start something. You get it. It's very important so that in future, you don't be depending on your parents. You get it. Yeah. And determine whether the students will be able to pursue their dreams and aspirations. We all can do something, right? We all have some aims. We all have some goals that we want to achieve. I stand here, I have so many goals that I want to achieve. And until me not achieving them, I'll continue to pursue those dreams. I know some of you here, you all have your dreams. Some of you want to be this, you want to be that. You have to sit down and know your way forward. You get it. Nobody is an outcast. You can do it. You get it. Other people have done it before, so why not you? You can also do it. So it's high time you believe in yourself, you believe in your goals, and know what you can do for the betterment of yourself. Thank you very much. Thank you.